He said, if you ever think about becoming a Christian, you will no longer be my daughter.
My name is Amara Campbell. I was born and raised in Pakistan. I was born and raised in Peshawar, Pakistan, and we moved to U.S., to the U.S. in 2003, in August 2003. I went to elementary school all the way to college. I got my bachelor's degree at UT Dallas, and that's where I met my husband in the last semester of my bachelor's degree. It was a Wednesday night. We both sat down in his truck, and we both knew that we were interested in each other. He said, I like you very much. And then he said, I care about you. And then he said, I want you to be in heaven with me. And that's where there was goosebumps. The concept of heaven is obviously introduced in Islam. We grow up with knowing heaven and hell. So he asked me to read the Bible with him. At the time, I have never touched the Bible. We have been told that it's corrupted. I said, I will look at the Bible with you if you can look at the Quran with me. My husband, Wes Campbell, he was able to learn about the culture of Islam. Because Islam is just not a religion, but it also comes with a culture of a really strong family background. God has his own ways to lead you to what you're seeking. I was able to come across this guy who wrote the book, Seeking Allah, Finding Jesus, Nabil Qureshi.
If we believe that God can do anything and everything, why are we limiting God's power to come on this earth that he created himself? Why can he not have a son?
Jesus was prophesied way back in Genesis when Adam and Eve ate the fruit from the tree that it was forbidden. Yahweh told Satan that he is going to crush your head. Who is he that is mentioned in that? And that's Jesus. What led me to the truth was this. If we get a sheet of piece of paper that's blank, you know, folded into two, on one side put Muhammad, on the other side put Jesus. Muhammad took lives so that people could come to Islam. Jesus gave his life so that we can be in heaven with him. That's when I knew that Christianity is the way that would lead me to God. I would go to church every Sunday, even as a Muslim. In my heart, I knew the truth, but I did not want to follow the truth because I knew the consequences. If you announce that Jesus is God and is the Son of God, Islam itself, if you become a Christian, they can execute you. When I talked to my dad about that, and I said, Dad, did you know that Islam allows to behead Christians, like, you know, to behead people that are innocent? He said, if you ever think about becoming a Christian, you will no longer be my daughter. So I was in a very big dilemma in my head because I knew the truth, and yet I could not accept it. I knew that once I would accept Jesus as my Lord and my Savior and as God, I would lose my parents. I would lose my connections with my family, with my brothers, with my sisters that I grew up with for the past 20 years. And one night I laid down in bed and I knew I was overwhelmed. I knew that I had been carrying this burden on my shoulder. All of a sudden, I closed my eyes and I said, God, forgive me, because I cannot accept you for who you are. And it was at that time that Jesus appeared to me. He had a great, wonderful, smiley face.
I would not call that a dream, because I was awake. It would be a vision, for sure. And it was at that moment that I decided to follow him, regardless of the consequences. What we need to do is keep our eyes on him, so that we can see that plan, so that we can hear him talk to us and tell us what we need to do.
I didn't have the courage, I should say, to tell my parents. I did not tell them face to face. I wrote them a letter. I love Jesus and I'm following him. I love the next day's feeling, which is April 20th. In that day, I didn't have to worry about carrying a burden on me. I can feel God saying to me, I am proud of you, my daughter. I'm proud of you.
Each one of us, God chose us to follow him. He has a plan for us and to leave everything behind, to follow the one that is true, the one that's the light, and the one that's the door.
God is reaching Muslims all over the world, and he is also meeting Hindus, Buddhists, agnostics, atheists, and people of all different faiths in unique and miraculous ways. he met me and reached out to me through someone who loved me enough to tell me the truth about Jesus. That he wasn't just a prophet of God, but he is the Son of God and he is God. And I'm so thankful that God has chosen me to be a mouthpiece for his love in this world.
بخواهید به شما داده خواهد شد. به جای پیدا خواهد کرد. بکوبید در بار روی دان باز خواهد شد. چون هر که بخواهد به دست می آورد و هر که بجوید پیدا می کند و هر که بکوبد در برایش باز می شود.